Belgium may not be much bigger than the state of Maryland, but it boasts 2,000 chocolate shops, most of them in the suitably sweet chocolate box city of Bruges. The locals are experts on candy and what goes into it, especially world-renowned Belgium nougat. For 8 decades, Nougat Vital has been perfecting this treat, today making 75% of Belgium's entire output. That mass production process is hidden in giant factory vats. So to see how they turn just 4 ingredients into this sticky treat, here's how they cook up a much smaller batch of Nougat Supreme. First, glucose and sugar are boiled in open copper kettles to 125 degrees Celsius. Nougat needs to be far sweeter than this, so next they ladle in rich Yucatan honey. But this would pour out of your chocolate bar as soon as you took a bite. The answer is to add the mix to stiffened egg whites, then stir to a sticky mass in a low-speed planetary mixer. And that's the basic recipe. But this factory churns out 500,000 pieces of nougat a day. And that calls for massive machinery. Hot nougat mix pours into conveyors like cement into foundations. And a sticky river stretching 250 meters slowly rises to the top of the factory. By the time it reaches Nougat Falls, the mix has cooled to 32 degrees and thickened into a dense carpet. Next, the nougat passes into an extruder, which flattens the lot to a snack-friendly 32 millimeters. It's sandwiched between 2 layers of wafer paper made from potato starch and sunflower oil and sliced into bars. But stack these sticky bars now and you'd never tear them apart. So they're conveyed to an elevator system to cool. It holds 10,000 bars. And as they rise and fall, the nougat gradually cools, and overnight, a little confectioner's magic occurs. A slight crust forms on the surface of each bar. This is called cruting, and it gives the nougat its trademark munchability. A few hours later, the bars emerge ready to be turned into nougat nuggets by the factory's prototype slicer.